So step three of our immune system is the specific immune response. And this is acquired. And what we mean by that is that we develop it through our lifetime. It's not something you're born with. And this is going to be our ability to recognize very specific pathogens. So it targets a specific pathogen, not just anything that's non-self. There are two kinds of specific immune response. Can be humoral, which means outside of cells, or cell mediated, which is inside of cells. So the pathogen could be around your tissues, in your circulatory system, or it could be inside of the cell. And you can kind of think about viruses are going to be more inside the cell, and maybe bacteria or a fungi might be more outside the cell. So we're going to talk about each one of these. The humoral response. This is a way to target pathogens faster for a more complete immune system attack. And so what I want you to think about here, again, sort of a goofy example, but if you have neighborhood police officers going through the neighborhood and sort of randomly pulling over cars and checking IDs, they're going to occasionally find someone who shouldn't be there. They're going to occasionally find some really bad individual, but a lot of times they're going to be pulling over individuals that are perfectly fine and should be right where they are. So imagine if we had a big red flag on every car that had a criminal in it. It would make the job for the cops really, really easy, right? Just look for cars with red flags and pull those guys over. So the specific immune response is an attempt to do just that. And that red flag is the antibody antigen complex. What is that? This is the result of our antibodies matching up and fitting with the pathogen's antigen. An antigen is a unique protein in the cell membrane of the pathogen. So antigens are unique proteins. Again, just like we have our self-proteins, they're the self-proteins of the pathogen. An antibody is a very small protein that has a unique shape that can attach on to that antigen. So we make antibodies, and our body will make tons and tons of different antibodies until they find just the right one to attach to the antigen. Once you have that combination, that complex, you're going to trigger a full immune response. So we have these certain kinds of B cells, which are a type of white blood cell, and they produce hundreds of millions of different antibodies. And the idea here is if you make hundreds of millions, one of them will actually fit onto the antigen. Here we have a virus, and the little red balls are the antigens that are sticking out of that viral capsule. And then antibodies have been made by our body, and when they attach to the virus, now the virus cannot attach to the host cell, and it blocks it from infecting. Then, like I mentioned, this red flag idea, when you have this antigen-antibody complex, the macrophage isn't going to spend the time to look at these proteins and figure out if they are supposed to be here or not. They're just going to engulf it. And so this is a faster immune response while also preventing future infections. So think about the antigen-antibody complex as putting a pathogen on the FBI most wanted list. Now, every kind of law enforcement officer, every kind of white blood cell is looking for that antigen-antibody complex. So all the white blood cells are on search and destroy, and it's a much faster way than just generally searching for non-self. This is going to work on bacteria, fungi, protozoans, worms, even viruses in the bloodstream or in the lymph system. So again, when we say that this is the humoral response, this is going to work primarily outside of cells. What's really cool is once you have made an antibody, you are now ready for future infections as well. So once the B cells have created a particular antibody that works really well, they're going to go through clonal selection, make more B cells that are ready to produce that antibody if that pathogen ever comes up again. And so you're essentially ready for that infection if it were to come again. So these next two videos are going to show you a little bit about how clonal selection works, how those antibodies are produced, and how that triggers the immune system to then fight any pathogen with the antigen-antibody complex.